Go.
Hello, Milton students. Welcome back for another session of your PE, Physical Education Videos of the Week. We hope that you've enjoyed the other videos that we've shared with your teachers, and you're enjoying the activities and getting outside and getting your 30 minutes of activity each and every day. Very important that you you try to set a goal every day to get at least 30 minutes of exercise, activity. Maybe it's a walk or a bike ride, but you're getting your 30 minutes in every day. If you're getting more than 30 minutes, that's even great, that's even better. And you can always use the PE videos as a guide to get your instructed PE lesson of the weekend every single week. Today's lesson is also a virtual field day activity event that we're going to be practicing. It's called the Paper Airplane Challenge, where you're going to be creating and making your own paper airplanes, and then we're going to be flying and gliding them in the air to try to land them or get them into a target or target zone. So we're going to go over all those rules and directions later. And for today's warm-up, we have a special warm-up called the Yoga warm-up for you today. And before we get to that, I wanted to go over our essential items again. If you're outside getting activity and you're doing lots of exercises, to make sure you're still getting your water and hydrating your bodies, okay? The warmer weather has arrived, hopefully here in Massachusetts, and being outside and getting exercise an activity, you have to make sure that you hydrate your body with some water. We also have our sunscreen again. Even on the non-cloudy days, when it's partly cloudy, you still should be applying your sunscreen. We have our hand sanitizer whenever we handle equipment or we pick up things in the yard. We're making sure our hands are clean and sanitized. If you have the hand sanitizer, great, you can use it on the inside, outside, the wrist of your hands after your activities are over. And if you do not have the hand sanitizer, again, you can use the warm water and soap. And our last item today, since the warmer weather is here, Coach Jones has noticed that there's been an increase in bugs and flies and mosquitoes, so we brought some bug spray out and applied our bug spray to make sure that we protect ourselves of all our little friendly critters and bugs that are going to be coming around with the warmer weather. All right. So today's warm-up again is called the Yoga special warm-up for you today. All right. Make sure you have your own little area, whether you're inside or you're outside, and make sure when you do the yoga that you're using your deep breathing techniques that we've covered in PE class. Inhale through the nose and an exhale through the mouth. Okay? Yoga requires a lot of balance, coordination, and focus. All right? So here we go for our yoga warm up. We're going to put our feet shoulder width apart. Again, here's your shoulders all the way down. And we're going to do some forward arm extensions. You put your arms up high to the sky and then you reach down slowly to the ground between the toes. Up. Coach Jones is breathing. Inhale through his nose, exhale through his mouth as he's doing these movements. Waking up, the ashes and dust. All the way up again. Stretch it all the way up. Reach up high. Bring it down again. And back up. Hands together. Squeeze those hands nice and tight. And release. Breathe out. And breathe in. And out again. One more for me, please. Bring it in. Squeeze tight. Inhale. And let it all out. Exhale. Let's do some neck rolls. Bring your feet in a little bit closer now. And we're just going to do some nice, simple, easy neck rolls. All the way around in a circle. down, you're going to switch direction. Okay, now we're going to do some arm twists. With your hands, interlock them. You put them together like this. This is a sideways figure eight. And it's going to side you. And come back to the front. Show you the other side. Shake it out. Very nice. Okay, that's what we call the tippy toe stretch. We're going to go all the way up on our tippy toes and reach our hands up to the sky at the same time. Let's go shoulder width apart again for this one. Hands down, and our tippy toes come up. Our hands go up and we reach high. And back down. And reach up, tippy toes up. All the way up, back down, and one more. Tip your toes up, and back down. Okay, that completes our yoga movement stretch warm-up of the day today. And now we're gonna be nice and loose and ready, shake it out a little bit, and we're gonna get to our paper airplane challenge activity. All right, so what I have here is I have just a normal piece of paper. It's an 8x11. I'm sure some of you, most of you have paper this size either in your house or possibly in your backpack or a folder. And just make sure it's a paper that you are not gonna be using for any future activities or homework assignments or anything like that. So you're gonna first start off. And it's a nice, easy four-step process to make your paper airplane. I've even spelled it out for you here on the paper. Step one, you're gonna fold your paper in half, okay? So take your paper, and you're gonna do a nice, easy fold it in half, just like so, okay? So that is step one. Step two, you're now going to fold the corners down. So open up your paper, and you're gonna fold your corners down, like so. So now, your paper airplane should look like this. You've got your two corners, they're folded down. Step number three, fold your corners in. Good. Now, I'm gonna take my paper airplane with the folded corners already, and I'm gonna fold these corners in one more time. Make sure you do both sides. Okay, your paper airplane looks like this. Step number four, fold your sides in half, okay? Take the inside where you've been folding and just fold one more time on each side. Okay, and then you'll have your paper airplane. Some of the paper airplanes that I've created and got a little artistic for you because I did some coloring on mine. All right, came out like this. You can design them and color them any way you would like. All right, I just made two separate airplanes. Okay, you can make as many as you would like, or if you just want to do one, that's up to you. But I did two paper airplanes for my challenge. because on the paper airplane challenge, again, you're gonna have 60 seconds to see how many times you can land your airplane into your target, all right? So, to show you paper airplane challenge, again, we have a starting position. Okay, we used some of our cones again, but if you don't have the cones, you can use a rock in the yard. Maybe you have a stick or a piece of wood that you can use in the yard. Somewhere where you know where to line up to start your paper airplane toss. Secondly, we have a target. We just have a big bucket here. If you're in the kindergarten or first grade, you're just gonna take two steps from your starting position. Okay, one, two, and set your target down. Okay, and you're gonna try to land your paper airplane in from there. If you're in grades two and three, you're just gonna take your target and move it back another step, so that's three steps, all right? So you're three steps away from the starting position. And if you're in grades four and five, we're just gonna push it back one more step. So you're gonna be back about four steps, your target, from the starting position, okay? For the purpose of this activity, I'm just gonna move it up to the first level up here. And if you're having difficulty landing your paper airplane into the target, one thing you can do is you can make a larger, wider, bigger target. I brought some of my extra cones out. And if I wanted to make a bigger target, I could just lay these cones out. And this could be my target zone too, to make it a little bit easier, okay? So I've expanded and I've increased the target zone for my paper airplanes. If you want a challenge, you can move your target to a decrease it in size, move it to a smaller landing zone. But again, it's all up to you. So I'm going to put my target zone back. I'm going to pick up these cones. And if you don't have cones, you can always use some rocks in your yard or some sticks, all right, to make your target zone for your paper airplane challenge. So we're gonna put 60 seconds on the clock again. And we're just gonna see how many times Coach Jones can toss his paper airplane into the target zone. After each time I toss my two paper airplanes, I'm gonna go retrieve them, run back to the start, and keep going, and then when the time's up, we'll see how many paper airplanes I've landed in the target zone. Okay. So when you do the paper airplane toss, one thing I can recommend is using one of our exercise movements, where almost like you're doing like a lunge, you bend your knees and you get nice and low. Because if I toss the paper airplane from here, it's probably going to go anywhere up into the air. But if I get low, I bend my knees and I perform like that lunge, I have a better chance of getting it into the target zone. Okay? So again, 60 seconds on the clock. Use a stopwatch if you have one. iPhone has a stopwatch app on there, or if you have a Fitbit that has a timer. If you do not have any of those items, again, you're gonna have to count the 60 seconds in your head. Okay? Keep in mind that all these activities are just practice. Try your best. And have fun and enjoy them, okay? So 60 seconds, ready, begin. Oh, there's one in. Oh, that guy likes to fly. All right, run out, I get my paper airplanes. I made two. Again, you can make as many as you'd like for your paper airplane challenge. I got two in. Maybe I gotta go a little bit lower with this one. Oh, he likes to glide. So I have two in. Get back to the start. Okay, bend my knees again, get low. There's three. Oh, I almost had him. Okay, back to the start again. Getting a little workout in here. There's four. Oh, I got him in. Five. And time. Okay. So again, have fun with your challenges and your activities. I'd like to see some pictures and maybe videos of your challenge activities that you're doing at home, or maybe you just can send me a picture of the paper airplane that you created. Again, my email is bjones@miltonps.org. Again, students, have fun with these activities, be safe, and I will see you next week.